refer to BWL students as the best and brightest. The class of 2018 has the distinction to be the best, the brightest, and the biggest. With 63 students, it is our largest graduating class in our 100-year history. As we celebrate the school's centennial this year, it is exciting to honor this most remarkable group of students. I also feel very, very privileged this morning to welcome our keynote speaker, the star of Saturday Night Live, Mr. Colin Jost. Now, to present the 13-year graduates of this class is the Lower School.
way back when the Russian president was Vladimir Putin. Like, way back. I also really liked seeing the 13-year club. Congratulations. It was really like acknowledging the people that have been in prison the longest. Where you're like, these are the ones who can really get stuff if you need stuff.
Chance to
Please, I hope that you do not take that opportunity for granted. Even in America, which is the land of opportunity, surprisingly few people have that chance. If you guys have that chance, I really hope you embrace it. Anthony Davis is a basketball player I really love. He plays for the New Orleans Pelicans. Hold for applause, okay. Well, as he said, he had a line that I really liked, and his line was, if you're not ready to be great, then step aside and let someone else be great. You have a chance to be great, and if you do not take it, someone else will. I'm guessing one of those jerks at your prep.
Get out and see the rest of the world, to see the rest of the country, because New York
real bubble, and you can feel like you have a grasp of what the world is, but it really can be very different, and it's important to see that other side, to travel, and to be tolerant, truly tolerant, in a way that people in New York aren't sometimes. Even people who are very liberal aren't necessarily always tolerant. Like, there's something about tolerance where you almost have to tolerate the idea of intolerance as well. Like, you have to be compassionate and try to understand where people are coming from in order to be able to really change their mind. I'm going to change this page. That's what I meant. I lost my place. Damn it, it's so wrong. Oh, this is a quote that I really liked from one of your famous alumni. I don't know if that's the last alumni. Barbara Walters. She said, "Deep breaths are very helpful in shallow hearts." That's a very New York helpful moment. Having been to many of those parties, I agree. Also, to quote Brooke Shields, "The tuition here is what?" My other advice for the class today is to always seek out people who are going to challenge you in your life. People who are better than you. Surround yourselves with people who are going to push you to succeed. People always come up to me and they ask, "What's your best advice for how to succeed in comedy?" And I always say, "Oh, no, I'm blowing glass." And if they don't fall for that, I tell them, okay, well, what I would say is surround yourself with funny people who really care about comedy, who really care about what they do. And that's true for really any field or profession you're going into. You have to find other people, and you'll do this in college or you do this after college, or maybe some of you already done it. Find other people who you love spending time with who are passionate about the same things that you're passionate about. You know, and sometimes in college it takes time to figure out who those people are, and you might not meet them until after college, but do not freak out. You will find those people. They might just be hiding from you because they're intimidated that you went to Birch Cloth Athletics, so they know it's ours. It's really important to not be afraid of people who challenge you and not be afraid of people who are better than you. My boss, Lauren Michaels, he always tells us that you never want to be the smartest person in the room. To which I always say, "Are you sure you don't want to be the smartest? I mean, I can leave." To which he always responds, "You're fired." I think the most important thing of all this is just to be resilient. The people that you find are most successful in life are resilient. They keep going. They don't care if they get knocked down. They don't care if they fumble. They don't care if they don't really know what's next. They don't make excuses. They keep going, and they use every opportunity they get. After today, after high school, your life will not get easier, but I do think it will get better. There will be new challenges, and the world is about to expand manyfold, and I think that's a good thing. You'll notice after this that your life will be defined a lot less by your parents and a lot more by your peers, so choose your company wisely. You'll notice there are a lot fewer rules after this, unless you're joining a monastery, in which case there are probably the same number of rules. Today you might feel sad, or you might feel nostalgic, and you might feel like this whole world, which is basically the only world you knew, is ending. But I assure you, it is not. You will come back here. You will visit. Even if it's just for graduation next year, to tell everyone how much you loved last year's speaker. The guy from SNL, I think his name is Pete Davidson. And you will remain close with many of the friends you've made here, probably for the rest of your life, because you share a very special bond, and that is the bond of having gone to Birch, Block Athletics, and Associates. So congratulations to the class of 2018. And no matter what the future holds, I think we can all agree, Columbia grammar sucks. Thank you very much. Thank you again.
This is the moment you've been waiting for. It is now my pleasure to present to you the members of the class of 2018. They have each successfully fulfilled the requirements of the Birchwalk Athletic School and are now eligible to receive our diploma. Jonathan Edward Abel. Thank you. Congratulations to the class.
Today we offer gratitude for all the faculty and administrators who inspired a new generation of courage. Today, we offer gratitude to you, the class of 2018, who rise as a new generation of our leaders. A new word was added to the Oxford English Dictionary this year. The word youthquake, defined as a significant cultural, political, or social change arising from the actions or influence of young people. This year we've been reminded in the face of darkness, the power of youth, our rising generation to inspire a country, to awaken us to our moral responsibilities, to reclaim for us the dream of what ought to be. Perhaps more than ever, it is your voice, your actions, we all so desperately need. As your journey now takes you beyond the walls of EWL, may the values of your educational home call you to shake every hall of learning and every place of belonging before you. And so when the world comes apart, may you be the ones to remind us